In this video, I will give you a lens to look at culture. This lens, with which you can examine a culture or compare cultures, is one way to approach the concept of culture, which means that there are also other ways to frame culture. So this is my disclaimer. The lens I propose here is actually focusing on relationships between people, about how they preferably interact with each other in a specific group. A starting point is that products are somehow mediators of these relationships. This will become clear in the course of this video. Based on these dimensions and other cultural theories, I composed a set of socio-cultural dimensions specifically for designers. They can be used for any cultural group, and not necessarily on a national level. And they should be used without the scores. This is important because through research we concluded that using scores are not suitable to use in design projects. Firstly, because users of products are often not organized by nation. And secondly, the scores are based on averages of large populations that do not necessarily represent the people where you design for. Even if the scores were good indicators for the preferred value orientation, then still there are so many factors that the designer could consider as important. For example, the product does not necessarily support existing values, but could be designed with the intention to change a culture or to bridge two cultures with each other. So just applying scores can be misleading. However, the dimensions are useful if you use them in a more qualitative way. For example, they can be used as a checklist to consider which values are important for you as a designer or for your project. It's important to be very specific about the imagined situation. Here you see how a design team used the list of dimensions to communicate the current, the red dots, and the desired, the blue dots. Value orientation they were aiming for when designing a ritual. Okay, in the next video I will explain these dimensions one by one. I hope to make clear with product examples what these socio-cultural dimensions that are in principle based on relationships between people can mean for you as a designer.